Beeswax is a non-toxic, clean-burning, soot-free candle. So much of our business is focused on people coming to us looking for totally clean alternatives. The cultivation and harvesting of beeswax in no way harms the hive. If you deal with any other wax, especially paraffin, which is what most candles are made of, is a byproduct of petroleum. When you burn paraffin, it's toxic. So it's like burning a diesel car engine in your room.
I always think it's really ironic when people are having a romantic candlelit dinner or sitting in a bathtub with all these aromatherapy candles, but in fact, they're actually breathing more pollutants than if they were outside on the freeway. Sometimes the air inside your home could be more polluted than the air outside.
Wicks these days are sometimes either coated or cored with lead, and it's no longer necessary. There are so many wicks out there that burn beautifully. It's a question of updating old technologies in Asia. And so generally a lot of the large box stores, Walmart, Target, whatever, you might find candles that are manufactured in volume in Asia, and they're bound to have lead core wicks and paraffin wax.
All right, let's go check out some stuff inside. It smells so good. What does that come from? Mostly the wax?
Today we're pouring scented beeswax, which is 100% pure raw beeswax combined with pure essential oils. Essential oils are hugely expensive. We might spend $20, $30 a pound on fragrance, whereas a chemical fragrance might cost someone $3, $6, $7 a pound at the high end. So this will hold about 100 pounds of molten beeswax. We're able to control the temperature of the wax really exactly, which is important because beeswax, if it gets too hot, will burn.
Oh, I like the hair clip system. How did you devise this?
High tech. Yeah, high tech. We're constantly running out of hair clips. This is Molly, our production manager, the queen of blue corn. Right now she's waxing some wicks, but essentially she's rolling.
Oh, that's wax.
She's rolling solid sheets of beeswax into pillars.
It's like one of my favorite jobs. It's like arts and crafts every day. Every day you're coming in and kind of experimenting with various things. Right now we're playing with the color samples and coming up with different colors, and there's always something new. It just makes it fun. Instead of like having a restaurant job and smelling like onions, everybody tells you how great you smell all the time.
You know, one of the beautiful things about this business is there's hardly any waste. All the cardboard that comes in either goes back out for shipping or gets used in our processes. The beeswax can get scraped off the floor, put into a special vat, and all the dirt will sink to the bottom. The beeswax will come out clean, or we'll lightly filter it. I mean, there's really almost no waste. On a weekly basis, we'll get rid of a trash can of trash for a business, you know, that's running full time with 6 employees. Bees are struggling against industrial agriculture. They use tons of pesticides on homogeneous fields, on huge acreage, and they produce as much as they can in a brief period of time in a very unsustainable fashion. The bee, in collecting pollen, will come by and collect pesticides, which will then take it back to the hive and release this pesticide into the hive, killing the entire hive. Agricultural process, which is so dependent on honeybees, is employing methods that devastate honeybees. The American beekeeper is a dying breed. I mean, they are few and far between.
I did it for a while, and it was really fun. And my bees were so gentle. They were so nice. Like, you could go up to the hives and even open it up without any of them trying to sting you. So it was so much fun. I absolutely loved it.
My hive is always talking.
Al Dustbury. It started for kids at risk.
It's about providing connections to oneself, to other people, to nature, to the horses, and opening up people through those connections.